You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download. And here we are with our shot in its current state. And I'm just going to do a couple of small things now to finish off this shot. One of the things I want to do is just add a quick relighting effect. And the other thing is to then just sort of add in a bit more color into it. And finally, we're moving away from the power mesh hand part of our tree. And we're coming back down to the bottom to add in the last few little bits. If we come into silhouettes light category, we do have some nice lighting nodes available to us, you know, including things like relight, which we could use just to let's maybe not have that parallel. There we go. Yeah, which we could use to add a little bit more texture onto here. Maybe not quite at that high strength, but we're not going to do that. Let's just get rid of relight, and instead I'm going to have a look in the Sapphire light category. And again, just like when we were using the wipe clouds, if you're using the plugin version of Silhouette, you won't have access to the Sapphire effects. These are only available when working in the standalone version of Silhouette. So we go into the Sapphire lighting here. I've got a nice one that's called S Spotlight. Let's bring this over the top here. And let's turn back on overlays. And at its base, it's a really simple effect. You know, we've got a lot of stuff we could do with it, but really what we're trying to do here is we've got two points. We've got a point where we're aiming at, which is the head, and where we're aiming our light from, which is probably over here somewhere. Probably over here. In fact, let's zoom out a little bit with the minus key. Maybe we'll take it out over here somewhere. Excellent. And then we can just come back into the parameters and look at things like the spread angle. So we can make this a little bit more focused and change up the softness. So we've got a bit more of a fall off, or a bit softer there, and maybe even change the fall off. So I kind of like having it, if not at zero, then pretty close to zero. There we go. So if I play that back now, we're going to see a little problem. And that problem's pretty clear when we run it through at full speed. Obviously, the light isn't moving at all with the rest of the image, so it just looks like it's stuck in there. You know, sometimes you could get away with it by saying, you know, the light's just stuck on the camera, but not in this case. So what could we do here? Like most Sapphire effects, Mocha is built directly into the effect. So we could go into Mocha, retrack this, and then apply that effect. Or we could do things a slightly different way. Take a little look at our spotlight node. And what do you see? Well, we have three inputs into it. We have the background, the image input. We have a mask that we can bring in if we need to mask it off. And we have a data input. This is kind of interesting, because remember, all the way back when we were doing the motion tracking for the arm, we did lots of different types of tracking back then. We did the point tracking and the planar tracking, and we have that data available to us from that data output. So let's bring that into the spotlight, and let's tidy this up now, actually, so we know what's going where. There we go. Color code these in just a moment. So now we have our data coming from the roto into the spotlight. Let's take a little look how we can use that now. If we have a look at the aim first, because that's the one that's on screen, let's take it a little bit further into the effect. There we go. What I can do now is that now we have a data input coming in, I've got a little drop down that shows me all of the different layers that I can start to take tracking data from. So if I use my planar tracking data here, and I'll do the same thing with my light as well, we'll come in and we'll offset this in a second, but look what's happening now. We just scrubbed through. You see the light is actually following now with the data that we've already tracked. And you'll find that a lot of Sapphire effects, where you have position or center point parameters, are able to take on that data. And similarly, if we look into Silhouette as well, and look at the transform, we've got the transform, the DOD, and coming in even into the light category again, we have that data port open to us in a lot of different effects for driving these types of parameters. So let's finish this off. Let's come back in, zoom out a little bit. And I can change my aim. And I can change my light. And because the motion's being driven by my planar tracking data and the roto node, that still looks right for us. Let's come in. Let's just finish this off just a little bit. I'm going to take the spread angle down even further now. Nice and soft. Hit F to bring us back into fit to view. Yeah, and that's looking good. That's what I want it to do. Excellent. All right, so the final thing we're going to do is just apply a bit of a color correction over the top of everything. We could do this manually with any of the color correction filters. But I think, you know, while I've got Sapphire open, might as well just take the easy road out, you know, here. We've done so much tough stuff manually. Let's make our lives easy for a second. And in Stylize, we have a node that's called ColorFuse. In fact, I'm just going to type in ColorFuse here. And there we are. So let's apply this after the spotlight. And what ColorFuse does, it lets us mix different creative LUTs together to give us a nice little finished effect. We'll have a little look at the presets now, back into our Sapphire preset browser, and we'll take a look at the presets here. Now the OFX version of ColorFuse doesn't always update the viewer here, so the best way to judge what the presets are is take a look at the thumbnails. So we have color film emulation, that's with C. We have black and white film emulation with BW. And we have big stylized things with S, and also a mixture of many things with M. And I think, let's have a little look. We've got maybe something like In the Morning or Modern Sportswear, something like that. Maybe we'll try Modern Sportswear. Yeah, that's going to be a bit better. We can mix the LUT strengths up as we see fit as well. So we can just kind of get a nice custom view. Maybe I'll pop back into Spotlight now. Make my Spotlight a bit brighter. I could even come down to the bottom here and just bump up the ambient brightness as well. And taking a look at our final effect there, I'm actually pretty happy with what we've achieved here. Maybe there's a little bit of fine tuning we can do with it. I think overall that's quite a nice little effect that we've built up. Join me in the seventh and final chapter when we look closer at outputting this and doing any final troubleshooting. We're also going to explore a new node called the DOD that's going to get us out of a lot of trouble when we're compositing layers of different sizes together. So join me in exercise 7.